Are you using the two-person one since Gordo's only here in voice? Tim?
Yes. What?
You're using the two-person one, right?
Sure. Yes.
You. Okay. I was trying to figure out. I don't know what's going on anymore. Tonight's GNL show is brought to you by Gordo's dead MacBook Pro. May it rest in peace.
Oh, are we having that moment of silence? Mm-hmm. All right. We'll have that at the midway of the show.
It only works if you're silent.
No. We'll have it at the midway of the show. No. We're having it at the midway of the show because it only lasted halfway through its lifespan.
Oh, okay.
All right.
So, in that case, welcome to the GNL show.
Tonight's guests are Greg C96. I'm Captain Hook 5150. We also have Gordo, even though he's not over there.
Yeah, we have Harley instead of Gordo. And roll
Harley's,
that in.
Harley's not actually here yet either, but she maybe here. I don't know.
From forth the questionable minds of Greg and Liberty, we bring you the GNL show.
Okay.
So, first things first, viewers, you may be like, what the hell, Greg? That's not your normal place. What are you doing going out in the world?
What are you doing, Greg, going out in the world?
I'm in Dallas, and it's miserable, and I hate it.
Dallas, Texas, during the summer. It's got to be nice and cool.
No. More than during the summer. In the middle of August.
Beginning of August.
Wow. So, kind of middle. It's the 7th.
There's 31 days in August.
It's anyway, 100 degrees.
It's 100, nice.
Man. And it's about 15% humidity. So that's not the worst, but, like, it's not
ideal.
Like 1.5, so it could be a lot worse. And I realized I didn't pack any freaking swim trunks because I'm an idiot.
What?
What are you, a dipshit?
I'm stupid. I don't know. Right? I'll just go down at midnight. No one else will be down there, right?
It's Texas. Everything's bigger. Never mind.
So, does that mean I'm going to feel inadequate?
I don't know, man. That's all you.
Oh, where the hell are we going with this? Yeah, so I'm in Dallas, so I'm going to get it out here now. No, I am not copying Tim, but I'm doing a week of vlogs this week. Because I don't have the ability to make other videos. Yeah. And I'm trying my best to stay in frame, but this chair is not helping the matter.
You're right.
Like, the lock on this chair and not let it tilt back, like, just doesn't work.
Yeah, those hotel chairs have gotten used and abused.
They've seen better days.
They have, yes.
What's going on with you guys? I've given my rant.
I've been working a lot. That's been it.
That's unfortunate.
It can be, yes. It's fucking awful. I haven't really heard anything in the way of technology this week.
Yeah, there hasn't been a whole lot that I've noticed.
Rumor has it that there's going to be a new operation for CSGO coming out supposedly this week, whether or not that happens.
I have also heard that rumor, but I'm not entirely sure if I believe it.
Yeah, I don't know if that'll come up with new maps then, too, I would hope.
I just want Santorini back in the map pool. I want Santorini back.
Don't think it'll happen, but we can hope.
But I hope, yeah.
Then they had the guns, the rifles, spray pattern, and all that stuff kind of fixed. The M4 A1S, the M4 A4, and the AK.
They messed with the rifles. How dare they? Yes. Actually, I'm okay with it.
So you can't sit there spraying.
It makes bursting and tap shooting better and spraying not a thing, which it shouldn't be a thing. Right. Not with the rifles. This isn't an UMP 45 or a P90.
Correct.
Yeah. UMP.
Mm-hmm. So I have a little bit of, like, technology-related news. I think it was last week we talked about how United Arab Emirates could make people face, like, $500,000 in fines for using VPNs.
Yes.
Well, they've officially spelled out what the hell it means and what's illegal, what's not. So the legality around the VPNs has not changed, and not all residents in the United Arab Emirates who use technologies will face imprisonment and fines. Mm-hmm. Basically, what they amended is... one, the amount of fines that offenders will face, and they modified the existing provision and imprisonment.
Wait, what's this for?
United Arab Emirates basically made a blanket statement that almost made it seem like anyone who uses a VPN in their country is breaking the law and could be fined up to $500,000 and face jail time.
What the fuck is a VPN?
Virtual private network.
Okay, thank you.
So basically, so misuse of the technology may still be punishable. So if people are using like VPNs to watch porn and things like that, I guess.
Yeah.
Porn. But like banks and companies and like stuff like that are not prohibited from using VPNs. So like basically nothing really changed as far as I can tell.
Right.
So I don't understand why they made the statement to scare everybody.
Those crazy Emirates. Because they live in the desert. It's too hot.
You mean like Texas?
Like Texas.
It's too damn hot.
Yes.
I'm a fat guy, so I don't like the hot.
I sympathize.
I sympathize.
I do. I went golfing this morning. It was nice at 8 o'clock in the morning.
I'm very confused by the chat right now.
Okay. Someone in the chat. I have to read the chat.
The chat's confusing me. Tim, what do you see? I thought you think, what should I do now with this two guys? My answer, talk with me, smiley face.
Who's talking?
That's the broke one.
Oh. Hi.
What?
What the fuck? Why? Oh, that's the cat cam. Okay.
Yeah, you're the cat cam.
Okay. I was like, what the fuck's the loot crate? Wait, are you sponsored by Loot Crate?
Oh, no. Tim, you gotta block the logo and the Steelers logo. Gordo said we're sponsored. We're gonna be screwed now. And we're gonna get
sued for
something Gordo said.
No, I said, are you sponsored? I didn't say we're sponsored.
No.
I'm not sponsored by
I'm not.
No.
I do not own Loot Crate either.
I am not sponsored by, nor do I own Loot Crate.
Nor do I have any stake in the company of Loot Crate Incorporated.
Nor do I.
But if you want now Pornhub, if you want to sponsor me.
I am very open to being sponsored. However,
I am not at this time.
I will sell myself out. Let's just get that straight. I'm putting it out there.
Yeah, we're willing to sell our souls for Loot Crate money. Thank you.
Any money. I mean, but it's not just...
Any money. Not
just narrow it down.
Real money, too. Real money is acceptable.
Yes.
Oh, you know what was funny? So, I was watching the Bo Burnham, what's it called? Cappy or whatever. That like, little special he has on Netflix. And so, there's a part in the show where he's down. He's like, this... what was it? He's like, this special is sponsored by... Flaming Hot Cheetos, Flaming Hot Cheetos, and it's like this whole entire thing. And he's like Flaming Hot Cheetos are better than regular Cheetos or whatever. And then he just goes, "I'm not sponsored by Flaming Hot Cheetos. I'm trying to get them to sponsor me.
I'm showing them what a sponsor spot would look like."
And then he grabbed a water bottle. He's like, "Labelless water. Nothing tastes better than not getting sued."
That's true. I'm down with that.
Allegedly, I don't want to get sued. Oh, great. We're going to have a DMCA takedown for the 5 seconds of game audio that Gordo just played. Damn it!
What game audio?
The shit that I hear right this second.
Oh, that's Batman Arkham Knight.
Yeah, we're going to get this game takedown.
I've been... they can't do any of that shit.
Yes, they can! Wait a second. Funny thing. One of my videos... Specifically, my live stream VOD that I put up. I gotta go check on my video manager real quick. I got a copyright strike.
On Twitch?
No, on the one I uploaded to YouTube, the stream VOD, I got a copyright strike on the video. Do you want to know why I got a copyright strike on the video?
Why?
I got flagged for one of Chris's songs. Chris's really? Company that published that particular song issued... a copyright strike against it.
No way. So you talked to Chris?
Yeah, I was just like, Chris, talk to your people.
Wait, he's under contract?
Apparently that one song was distributed on YouTube by a company by the name of CD Baby.
Hmm. Who the fuck is that? Does he even know that?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't even know he... So he got... really? So was he, like, paid by someone for that?
Well, I mean, not from my video. He didn't make shit.
Well, yeah, but I'm saying, like... Well, so... Oh,
so, no, I just opened up my video manager. So the strike is gone, so now I have to go set up ads on this video. Yeah. Ads are now back in place on that video since I can now monetize my content.
But isn't there, like,
a... I have express rights from Chris that I can use his music, and I get a copyright flag for it.
Yeah.
Duh, hell. Wait,
but wait a minute, isn't there a new rule on YouTube, though? Because now you kind of brought up a good point of this. That basically says that they won't get any of the money until, like, it's all settled. So, like, if you kind of acknowledge, yeah, okay, yeah, yeah. Okay. So either way, you wouldn't have gotten shit. Which is a great rule, by the way.
Yes, no, I 100% agree. So I would have gotten any of my money anyways. Yeah. Which is, I get that whole 2 pennies.
Yeah, woo! I mean, in general, the rule still doesn't help the
gotta pay the like bills.
Give me that cash.
Cash money.
Well, you know, you're not getting paid on YouTube, right?
I mean, between ad revenue and, like, Patreon and stuff, I make about $10 a month.
Oh, you fucker. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, no, I'm serious. I make about $10 a month. Tim's responsible for about 9 of that.
Wait, you actually donate? Oh, my God, I would not...
Yeah, he's one of my wonderful... He's my only patron.
See, like, I don't donate to people for a big reason.
Please explain this. I'm curious.
They're, like, big YouTubers I don't. Because, like, they don't need the fucking money. Right. Like, that's how I've always... Like, when I see, like, someone go, like, please donate to my Patreon. I need money. It's like, wait, don't you have, like, millions of dollars off your, like, what's it? You make a ton of money off your Twitch that you have.
Well, isn't that why, Review Tech USA stopped his Patreon?
Yeah, and then he asked if people wanted to make it. And if, like, yeah, if your audience is up for it, then sure, like, I guess why not? Like, why not, you know, make a Patreon? But in my head, it's like, I mean, that's why Review Tech USA stopped. He's like, yeah, this is fucking stupid.
Oh, hold on, wait. I'm gonna interrupt you. Apparently, the broke one in chat is saying that it was just a prank. It was a social experiment, and I was pranked by him. That's why my video got flagged.
Get pranked! Got him! High five.
Oh, got him!
Oh, is this the halfway show? Were we in the halfway show?
We're literally 13 minutes in.
All right, let's just do the halfway mark. Here, let's have a moment of silence.
Okay, fine. Throw up the sponsor card.
Oh, can we get... We didn't get any music for this, did we?
Nope. You said moment of silence!
Okay, well, we need music. Right, first, let's have the... All right, I'll do the little music.
Hold on, wait, let me send you a Chris Berry song so this can get DMCA takedown.
No, I got a song.
Hey, do you?
I got a song. It's not copyrighted, don't worry.
Better not be.
All right, so we'll just start off ready. I can, if you want, I can sing it.
Okay.
All right. Tim, just tell me when you press play in the link.
What do you mean play? It's going.
Just tell me when you press play. Just tell me when you press play in the link.
All right, play.
That computer was shit, massive shit. I ended up giving it to Greg to fix, and then I decided to just trash that shit. Shit, shit. Apple, fix your shit. Shit, shit. Your hard drives are garbage. Garbage, garbage. I actually lost my computer. Computer. Now I have to fucking pay more money because I didn't want to pay your shit. Shit, shit. Fuck you, Apple. Your Apple chargers are garbage, garbage, garbage. They are garbage, garbage, garbage. And I want to just let you know, so suck my dick, bitch.
I'm curious what song he was rapping that to.
I don't know. I just watch. We're gonna get like DMC because that song probably exists.
I'd be impressed if it did. But no, hold on, wait a sec. I just gotta say one thing, Gordo.
Yeah.
The hard drives that Apple uses in their computer, the brand on them is HGST.
Mm-hmm.
They have like a significant margin of lower percent failure rate than every other brand on the market. Like, they actually use... It's remarkable to me that you actually had a drive fail.
Really?
Wow. I'm trying to get the exact stat right now. So the annual failure rate for HGST hard drives... Come on, stop playing advertisements, you piece of shit website. I hate you. So the average failure rate is anywhere from between 0 on the low end to a high of 1.74%. So they average about a little bit below a 1% failure rate per year.
Holy shit.
Toshiba, which I consider a terrible brand of hard drive, sits at about 8.63.
Yeah.
Seagate, which I also consider terrible, sits at about 9.63. And Western Digital, that I considered a good brand, sits at about 12.57% failure.
Wow. Mm.
So, like, HGST, their failure rate continually drops, just like every other brand is continually dropping. But, like, they're significantly better than everybody else right now.
Huh.
Are we talking about the same amount of hard drives?
We're not doing the moment of silence, are we?
No, we're discussing this topic of you were complaining about their crappy hard drives. And
it's part of the song, Greg. Okay.
Wait, are you saying are they testing the same amount of hard drives in total?
Yes.
Yes, they are.
Of each brand, you know.
Yeah. Yep. Exactly. Yeah. To make it a good fair test, let me just pull up the notes real quick again. Actually, let's see. What is it? Yeah, they're testing about the same amount of drives. The only discrepancy is with Toshiba. Or not Toshiba, with Seagate, they tested a significant amount more drives by about 50%. Which, if anything, you would think would give Seagate a better chance.
You would think.
But no, they still had a higher failure rate.
They're shit!
So with that benefit, they still managed to produce a higher failure rate. So, like, literally less than 1% of HGST hard drives fail.
It's impressive.
Yeah, it is. That's why HGST OP. And I really, really want HGST to make solid-state drives. I don't think they do. I'm going to look it up real quick. I'm not sure.
Do it.
Oh, okay. They do make solid-state drives, but, like, enterprise solid-state drives.
What's that?
So they're, like, a couple grand.
Oh, never mind.
Nope.
Greg, yeah. You shaved.
I did, actually.
Wow. Well, I was shaving. I
figured it was going to be a miserable time in Texas.
Well, it will be anyway, but...
I got a haircut. My hair is no longer stupid long.
Wow.
Uh-huh.
Almost look respectable.
Took out the Clippers and did both last night.
That'll do it.
Yep.
You know, Gordo's a hobo.
Yeah.
I look like shit. Literally, I look like shit.
So there's a website by the name of Torrents. It's a torrent with a Z on the end.
Yeah.
Apparently, it is like the largest torrent meta search engine. It has been shut down.
Boom!
On August 5th, it disabled its search functionality and now refers to itself in the past tense. The site users are no longer able to log into the website either, just like the users are not. And now the website just says, Torrents will always love you. Farewell.
Rip.
And it has a little gerbil thing below it.
Dicks out for Torrents.
Ah, Harambe. Okay,
can we get some 1Gs in the chat?
Oh my god, I've been doing that so much now. So, what was it? I think it was Tuan at work told me this. I guess the day that the whole Harambe thing happened in Overwatch, everyone was playing as the monkey Winston.
That's fantastic way.
Yeah.
Relive.
And dude, I fucking hate Winston though. Oh my god, playing as Winston in that game is... I think I got into more of an argument with him when I was talking to him about it. He's like, well, if you have two Winstons, he's great. I'm like... Yeah, but I'm talking about Winston, not two Winstons.
Talking
like,
about Winston, not Winstons.
Yeah.
Like, there is a difference.
Yeah.
I like playing with Mercy.
I have not yet played
with one's Mercy? Oh, the healer. That's right. Yep. She's so annoying sometimes, though. Well, like, she's one of the... She can be really annoying, like, to go up against, because, like, all of these random dudes, like McCree or, fuck, what's the other one now? I can't remember. Get right behind her, or right in front of her, I should say.
Yeah. Yeah.
And just, you'll get fucking dunked on. It's horrible.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to sit back and enjoy the chat because I have not played Overwatch.
How have you not played Overwatch?
It's fun to play.
Because I don't own it. That's how I've not played Overwatch.
That'll certainly be a block in the road to playing it.
Yeah, it will. So, let's talk about something that Gordo will like.
Sure.
The Xbox One S.
Ooh.
It was released August 2nd. Yes. As a GPU clock speed higher than the older version of the Xbox One.
I would hope.
Oh, yeah, but this.
4K.
Which most people don't have 4K TVs.
4K UHD Blu-ray and 4K video streaming are supported. Actually, you'd be surprised. A lot of people do have 4K TVs now. It's
really
more and more common because the price is coming down.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, but like, it's gonna take a couple next, like, another year or two.
Yeah,
like,
but now they have the technology in place.
Oh, you know what's funny though? So when the Xbox One was like announced or whatever, like the new Xbox One, they asked Phil Spencer, like, okay, so like, how's this all gonna work? And he's kind of like, well, if you don't have a 4K TV, then this Xbox One is not for you. And then like, you just kind of just go, Phil, shut the fuck up. Like, what are you doing?
I mean, at least he's honest.
Yeah.
He's honest, but you, like, that doesn't sell.
Well, no, and here's the dumb thing. There's going to be a new Xbox One coming soon anyways. Again.
I know.
Because they didn't use HDMI 2.0.
Right.
So they can, in 4K, it can only do 30 FPS, not 60.
Right.
That's dumb.
Right.
And it automatically upscales 1080p stuff to 4K, which I guess is kind of nice, because it works perfectly. If you have, like, 4K, as in 30... 8-something by something-something and not true 4K, but, you know.
Yeah.
I don't want to get into that because I'll start yelling.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Oh, you know, so...
Shit, I'm out of frame. I'm sorry. Not professional.
Speaking of stupid things, so today a customer came in to buy, what's it called? Apple, or not Apple TV, Amazon Fire Stick TV. And so I was like, okay, maybe we... You know, like, the Amazon Prime memberships?
Yes.
So I was like, okay, maybe I could just sell her one of those too, because like, it makes sense. Like, it saves her like money on like whatever, like, you know, movies or whatever. And so the manager was like, "So you're trying to send her to our competition?" I'm like, "Listen, that they do that. Like, the company does that for themselves. Like, we're basically, no matter what we do, we're sending them to the competition because our prices are fucking atrocious. Like, I could get way better prices at like just." Down to like some shitty store that needs the money, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It makes sense, like, but like, it honestly, that'd have been like a $200 sale if we did. If you think about it, like, so it made a lot of sense.
So what happened? Did you tell a customer to go to Amazon instead of selling them stuff?
No, I sold them the thing. I just said like, what you could do is you could also get like a membership for it, and I thought we sold memberships in store, which we don't for whatever reason. Which, I mean, I get why, actually.
So wait a second. That you're not supposed to do that. I've told so many customers over the past month I would just recommend going to Amazon.
You're not supposed to do that. But
so
like,
bad.
No, but like I sold it at the Amazon Fire TV, but I said like get the Amazon like Amazon Prime too. You're saving
Best
saving.
Buy.
Yeah, go to Best Buy. I said to her, I was like, you're gonna save a lot of money later on, you know. And then I was just in like the lockup with the manager and. He's like, so you basically send her to our competition, and I just kind of
wait
like,
a second. Hold up, we do not sell Amazon Fire or Amazon Prime content in store.
We sell Amazon Fire TVs.
That's fine, but if she bought the Fire TV from you,
yeah,
then what's the difference? Because we can't give her Amazon Prime, and we can't give her Amazon Fire TV content, and any money she spends on the Fire TV content doesn't go to us. So what the fuck? They were wrong.
He was making a point like,
and that's why I quit again.
Well, so he said, this is the point he made. He was like, so you basically, by you saying that it's on, like, to go get Amazon Prime, you just kind of took it away from here. But like most people, I've actually met a lot of people that don't know that you can get cheaper prices on Amazon, like through Amazon Prime. No one knows that, like, until like they really investigate it.
So then why?
And I'm like, oh, I just found a great.
Why are you telling them? You're breaking the system. You're going to make all the general managers of Staples not be able to put food in their mouths.
No, like, I don't tell customers, like, family, like, just friends and stuff. Like, their parents, I'll hang out, like, when I hang out with them, I talk to them for a few minutes. I'm like, why do you, like, waste money on this crap? Like, they're like, oh, well, I can go to, like, well, like, they're like, oh, I need this soon. And I'm like, and they're like, well, and they think it's fun. And they, like, see a great deal. I'm like, not a deal, because you got Amazon Prime.
Kevin,
like, I'm just staring at what's he doing.
Your mic's fucked up.
Yeah, my everything's messed up. Hotel internet.
Oh. It's just so hard to hear what you're saying.
I'm sorry! I'll be louder!
No, but, like, I'm just explaining something. Like, come on. Yeah. But, like, that's just how it is. Like, I just don't like lying to someone and saying, like, you're not saving money. Like, it's just fucking stupid. I like saving money, too. Like, it's, like, I don't like telling a customer, like, a bullshit lie, you know?
Saving money is...
Cause, like,
Hold on, can I just interrupt you real quick? Of course Tim's internet is totally perfect. Tim is at home with his almost gigabit connection. I am in a hotel. Sorry, I was answering the chat.
Oh.
Can we... Okay, Greg's internet effed up. Tim's internet is total perfect. He's at home.
I am at home.
Hey,
now.
Tim. Tim is like kind of like it.
Maybe it's your connection.
Maybe.
You ever think of that?
Nah.
Roasted.
I could be using my headphones too, or just starting to get out of the tubes.
Maybe.
Or all the heroin.
So
then again, I'm witnessing Greg just like lying out before my eyes on the screen. So.
Probably. So I'm gonna try to talk before I get lagged out and everything breaks.
But yeah, like that's just like I don't like sitting next to a customer going like, "Hey, listen, you're not like everyone wants to save money, especially like times now. Like it's not good. Like it's
the jobs are tough.
Well, they are. Like it's just people like a lot of people are looking for the same money. They're just like, yeah, it's $100 you got to fork out. But like, listen, you're saving a lot of money. Like new video games on Amazon, I get them for $4, like pre-order."
As opposed to 60.
Yeah.
That's not bad. Oh!
Yeah.
Ha.
Well, it says it's 60, but then after, like, you kind of purchase it, it goes like, it's
figured out why my internet went to hell. I was trying to figure out what Tim was doing, because I heard him giggling in the background, so I started playing the stream. That's why my internet went to hell. I stopped the stream again. Should be good. Yeah. So... Remember how we were talking about how Chris accidentally tried to take down one of my videos? That reminded me of a topic. So you know the site Getty Images?
Yes.
So, the firm for Getty Images demanded $120 from an artist by the name of Carol Highsmith for an alleged copyright violation of her own photo. So apparently she's a well-known American photographer. I've never heard of her. I'm sorry, Carol. I'm sure you're a wonderful human being. I don't know who you are, though. So, the specific photo was one she donated to the public domain, and Getty Images has been selling them.
Oh!
So,
what little bastards.
So, her claim in this lawsuit now that she's filing against them is they have been wrongly selling copyright licenses for over 18,000 of her photos that she had donated to them for free via the Library of Congress.
Oh.
According to the lawsuit, her gift continues to the present as she continues to take new photographs. Ars Technica, the website there, has searched for Highsmith's photos on Getty Images and sees they've all been removed from the website. And according to the suit, Getty and its affiliates have not only sold unauthorized licenses of Highsmith's photos, but have sent threatening letters to people who they believe have infringed the copyright. Wow. Because, you know, there's no copyright. It's free.
Yeah.
It's public domain.
What little bastards.
How dare they? Why do companies think they can get away with this crap?
Because they think that they're too big that people won't challenge them.
And then they accidentally send a cease and desist to the artist.
Yeah, oops.
Oopsie. I bet that intern got fired.
Yeah, for sure.
Because you know it's an intern.
Oh, yeah.
Or, no, it was an intern.
Not anymore.
Oops. He's at Stop and Shop now.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. He's allegedly at Stop and Shop now, according to the facts and figures I just pulled out of my ass.
Yes.
So, I think we've talked about VR stuff before. I have this upcoming Tuesday, so not like 2 days from now, but the Tuesday after that, I have a HTC Vive versus Oculus Rift video going out. But
Microsoft is pretty close to releasing its HoloLens augmented reality headset.
Sounds fancy.
$3,000.
Sounds expensive.
Sounds stupid expensive. You could buy 3 Oculus Rifts and a computer. Or actually, let me rephrase that. You could buy 2 Oculus Rifts and a way overpowered computer to run them for $3,000.
Actually, I can't speak today. You can buy an HTC Vive, an Oculus Rift, and a computer with a 1080 in it for the price of the Microsoft HoloLens. That's just not good marketing.
No, what makes it... How do they justify having it that much... I can't speak today.
How can
they justify having it cost that much?
Because of some of their features.
Like?
So basically they've done things like they've used it for training aircraft mechanics and flight crews and helping golf pros and fans to get more out of the game. Ooh. Those are some of the examples they've done. Yeah, Tim's like, I'm going to have to buy this now. Yeah. But apparently, so it's not specifically like virtual reality, it's augmented reality, which basically means it's integrating the real world and a virtual world.
Okay.
I'm not totally on board, but I guess some of the features include a kiosk mode so it can limit which apps are... words are hard. It can limit which apps are able to run, so they can enable like a demo or a showcase mode. It has Azure Active Directory and next-generation credentials with PIN unlock. They offer mobile device management, so an IT department can manage multiple HoloLens devices simultaneously. So it almost sounds like the HoloLens will be able to run on its own? Question mark?
Maybe.
That would be cool.
Yeah.
Windows Update for Business, controlled operating system updates to devices and support for long-term servicing branch. Work Access can remotely connect to corporate network through a VPN on the HoloLens. So yeah, it sounds like it's a standalone device. And Windows Store for Business, IT department can set up an enterprise private store containing only your company's apps for your specific HoloLens usage. Okay. Now I can see where they're justifying the three grand.
Yeah.
And it's a relatively like small and good looking headset too.
Yeah, the other ones can. That's the one thing I don't like about the other ones. They look like they'd be top heavy.
All right, so the Vive is a little bit. The Oculus Rift, the consumer version, like the previous like development kits and stuff, were definitely a little hefty. But the Oculus Rift consumer version, the outer construction of it is all mesh instead of a solid plastic, so it looks like nice and clean, and it's actually pretty lightweight. Like, the Oculus headset feels good, except for one of the things that I talked about in my video is both my mom, my sister, and then myself, when wearing the Oculus Rift headset, we got a little bit of light bleeding around the nose. So, like, you could see light coming in around the nose bridge.
Oh, not like blood bleeding.
No.
I'm like, damn, you got it too tight, bro.
Whereas with the HTC Vive, it was just literally the screens. There was no light getting let in around the edge of the headset.
Okay.
So, I guess in that sense, the HTC Vive felt a little bit nicer in, like, actual use. However, I like the feel of the Oculus headset better.
Okay.
So let's see if I can get Microsoft to sponsor me with a HoloLens to add that into the mix and give a potentially positive review. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Right. The ones that you tested, did they get like too hot on the inside?
I didn't notice it. The only thing is, hold on. What do you mean, like the device itself, or like you?
Like you.
I mean, I was sweating a little bit after like an hour and a half of use.
Oh, okay.
It wasn't too bad.
All right.
And the thing is, like, you're not getting like sweat in your eyes and stuff because it's a foam piece that goes around the edge.
Gotcha.
So I would just recommend like actually cleaning them.
Well, I would hope so. Gordo, wake up.
Hi, what?
Yeah, Gordo, are you gonna like do something today with us? Are you gonna talk to us?
I don't know. Like, I just don't. I don't know. Heroin. Who likes heroin? You get a T-shirt. I get a T-shirt. We all get T-shirts. Who wants a T-shirt? Oh, yep. Rest in peace. Moment of silence.
Okay, enough silence, BS. So Google Maps is working on an update to show how bad parking is at your destination.
Oh, yeah. I like that.
That's an idea. Fantastic. Yeah. Potentially going to include text-based alerts informing users to parking shortages at their destination. That's going to be awesome. Potentially will allow you to account for both traffic and parking scarcity at your destination to choose maybe like a nearby location to go to maybe.
Yeah.
Service will likely be based on total number of spaces available in a given area, taking into account time of day and nearby public events. And the update will also includes a feature that will fix when you accidentally reorient the direction of the map, keeping it in an always point north mode.
Okay.
So that's a separate thing that's part of the update. But the text-based alerts for parking is currently in beta, and it sounds amazing. Sorry, I just, my French fries, I tasted them again with a burp.
Ooh, yummy. Yeah, I like that idea. Not
the second time.
I bet nothing usually is. But I like the idea about being able to see about the parking. That looks, I like that.
Yeah, like that sounds amazing. But
yeah,
let's see how it works is the real question.
Yeah. It'll just take some time to get the bugs out and everything, but
yeah, exactly. So I think we've previously discussed how I'm jumping around from topic to topic. My brain is fried. I've literally been up since 5 a.m. and I've been traveling all day.
That'll
do it. All over the place. So Google, I think Microsoft might even offer it too, but the most specific one I remember is Google offers this thing with a Chromebook. If you can create any type of malware or exploit for the Chromebook and report it to them, they will pay you, basically.
Ooh. Sounds like a challenge.
Exactly. It's a challenge I've actually been working at. But basically, it's if you can get the exploit to stay around in their guest mode. So it's actually super hard to do.
Yeah,
I think it's like $250,000 that they'll pay out or something like that. Or maybe it was like $50,000. I don't remember. There's a couple of different programs that exist with different money values. So Apple did this a couple of years ago where the winner of the competition got the MacBook Pro that they were trying to hack. So that was a cool prize. But Apple's doing it again with iOS and iCloud now. They're calling it the Bug Bounty Program.
Ooh. Catchy.
So, for figuring out any secure boot firmware stuff that allows you to hack into the iDevice or an iCloud bug, they'll pay up to $200,000. For the extraction of confidential material protected by the secure enclave, they will pay up to $100,000. For execution of arbitrary code with kernel privileges, up to $50,000. So for that one, they don't want you to like actually make a virus. They just want you to make something that runs like a virus would and not hurt the thing.
Right.
Access from a sandbox process to user data outside of the sandbox, you'll get up to $25,000. And unauthorized access to iCloud account data on Apple servers, they'll give you up to $50,000 to prove that you know how to prove that you can do this and there's a bug. So basically, they're offering monetary incentive for the public
to hack.
Monetary incentive for the public. One, I guess, to really learn more about devices and get a kind of a technological education. But two, be their security testers.
Yeah.
Because when you have regular people doing the security testing, I guess maybe like people, I don't know. Maybe they're more confident in the fact that it's actually true. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about anymore.
It's all right.
So do you have any topics, Tim?
No, I don't.
Do you have any topics, Gordo?
Of course I don't.
Let me see if I can pull one or more.
Oh, Suicide Squad came out. Holy shit.
That's right. It did.
That's what I want to talk about. So yeah, that looks fucking amazing, but like I've heard a lot of terrible things about it.
Like what?
Which is, you know, I just heard it was like it's pretty obvious of what happens. Like,
so it, like, the,
Hold on. Well, like, the people that, I guess it's like the people that die, like, you think are gonna die are gonna die, and like the villain's terrible, the characters, like, most of the characters are pointless, besides like Will Smith and Margaret Robbie. The Joker was decent. Like, I've heard what?
I just wanted to address one specific thing. Sorry, I was just like, shut up for a second because you just kept talking.
Oh, I couldn't really hear you, but go on.
So many people have been complaining about, like, the Rotten Tomatoes bad reviews and, like, the critic reviews and stuff. Who in their right mind watched the trailer for Suicide Squad and was like, this movie's going to be critically acclaimed?
Yeah. Well, because this is the problem. People were like, it's going to be like, what's it called? Guardians of the Galaxy. And it's like, no. Guardians of the Galaxy is, like, one of those diamonds in the rough that you're like, you have no idea who these, like, it's like a... It's a comic book movie that no one knows the comics too. People kind of knew who Suicide Squad was. Like, people know who, like, Harley Quinn is and stuff. But even if you don't know, like, you don't follow comics, you are going to know who Harley Quinn is. You know who the Joker is. You've probably heard of Killer Croc. You've probably heard of Deadshot. Like,
I would say you know who the Joker is. I don't know if Harley Quinn
is common. I think just because of, like, the Batman games and, like, just Harley Quinn's now so tied to that character of the Joker that it's she's pretty well known at this point. Like, that's Joker's Robin, essentially, I would say. Just the
girls around here dress up as Harley Quinn at Halloween. Yeah. It's nice.
Yeah, it's Harley Quinn's a big character.
How Gordo totally ignored the last half of your statement.
That's fine.
No, I heard that girls dress up as Harley Quinn. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, that didn't surprise me. Yeah, I've seen that. It's not like, that's something crazy.
Yeah, just continue.
Yeah. It's just one of those things. It's like, you know, I'm going to go see the movie on Wednesday, I think, with some friends. But and I'll probably next GNL talk about it or something. But just, like, people are freaking out because, like, this is the thing with reviews. Reviews are just people's opinions. And, like, the people on Rotten Tomatoes, I think, just have popular opinions. Like, people who are professional who do reviews for a living, that's honestly, they just have popular opinions. Honestly, you shouldn't complain that some dude said, hey, this movie's fucking atrocious, don't go see it. It's like, if you enjoyed the movie, okay, you enjoyed the movie.
Yeah.
Like, don't bitch about it. You enjoyed the movie. You can maintain that you like the movie, and you can give your points as to why you like the movie.
I don't believe in the whole telling people that they shouldn't go see a movie thing.
Yeah, I mean,
there's some bad movies. But I would never tell someone not to go see a movie because, like, everyone can get something. Like, I can't think of a movie that I literally found zero entertainment out of.
I could name a couple right now.
What are a few of them?
Is there an Airplane?
Batman v Superman. That was fucking... That movie was bad.
Okay. I can honestly say I have not seen that one, so that could be totally correct.
So I was in the theater and I got up and walked out of the theater. Like, cause I was so pissed. I just went by myself.
That's probably
like,
when it got good, Gordo.
No, a lot of people said, like, this is, so I stayed it to the point where everyone said it got really good. And then I went by myself cause I was like, okay, I don't want to have some assholes. Like, cause the last time I went to a movie with some friends, part of it got spoiled. So I was like, okay, forget it. Like, and then, or they would talk to me while I'm trying to watch the movie.
Go,
so I said, I'd rather just not do that. So, but what happened was, I sat there and, like, I forgot what point in the movie, but it was supposed to be, like, climactic points in the movie. And I was like, yeah, this is fucking garbage. And I got up and walked out. I might give it another shot and just watch it on, like, my Apple TV, but it was bad. Like, the thing is, the DC universe, like, the DC movies, they're not doing them right. And people were like, well, they need to do more, like, lighter tone movies. I'm like, no, the dark tone works for DC. It works really well. They just aren't doing it right.
You know what I want to see? What comic brand I want to see start having movies?
What?
I want to see freaking Dark Horse movies.
Garfield.
Well, that doesn't count.
That's a movie. Oh. They made a movie out of Garfield.
Spoiler.
I mean, like, old Dark Horse comics.
Wait, which ones? I mean...
My last band's name was Dark Horse.
Really?
Copyright infringement? ?
No? ?
Wait. What? Like, what properties do they have? I think they have, like, Star Wars, but, or I don't think they used to actually. I don't think they have Star Wars anymore. I could be wrong though. What properties do they have though?
Like,
I really would like to see a Boris the Bear movie. Maybe I'm alone in that.
Yeah, you're gonna be alone.
Paddington Bear.
The fuck? I don't know any of these. The thing is, like, the thing that DC is doing extremely wrong, and I don't think they've ever they've realized this yet, is the fact that they're really late to the superhero game. Like, they had, like, the Dark Knight, and that's cool.
Okay,
like,
hold on. Whatever. No, Wizard of Fourth Street would make a good movie, I think.
I don't know any of these. See, superhero. So here's the thing: superhero movies are, like, the most interesting movies to go see because, like, everyone dreams of being a superhero, right? Whereas, like, when they, like, just. And the Marvel movies are doing it right because they spaced them out and now they've built this empire that can't be touched. Whereas DC's like, okay, we're gonna have the Flash and Aquaman.
Quick! We gotta do it now!
Oh yeah, I was like, well, I was just confused. Yeah, but they're doing like Aquaman and then the Flash right after the Justice League movie, and I think Wonder Woman's literally right before Batman comes out after. And none of it makes sense. The timelines are terrible. This is how I think they should have done Batman v Superman. I think they should have waited because part of the movie felt a little bit like the Batman origin story, and I was like, oh, fuck, here we go. Like, I knew that going in, and then and this is the thing that's going to be really, really hard, and I think this is what's going to happen. In the Justice League movie, I think they're going to cram part of the origin stories for, like, Aquaman, The Flash, Cyborg, because I don't know if Cyborg's getting his own movie. They're going to try to do those, I think, and it's going to be, like, really annoying. They're going to do, like, a probably 15 minutes maybe, or like 10 minutes for each, and that's 30 minutes of a movie, and that's bullshit to me. Like, I mean, if they can cram it in like 5 minutes, great, but that's still part of a movie that you shouldn't have to do. Like, you shouldn't, like, once the the Avengers came out, the only ones they had to do were like Hawkeye, and no one gives a shit about Hawkeye. Like, you kind of get the idea that Black Widow is, because they kind of address it multiple times in each of the movies, but like, for just, I mean, the Hulk was different because, like, Edward Norton got fired and they had to do, I think they had to do that as well. So they kind of had to, like, give you, like, just kind of brief summary, like, who the Hulk was, like, or this version of the Hulk, at least. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because, like, this Hulk was, I think, a little different, if I remember correctly. I haven't seen that movie, the Edward Norton Hulk, in a while, but they fucking let Edward Norton go fast. Like, they were like, screw this. They couldn't take it anymore.
So,
well, because he was taking control of the movie. Like, I would agree with it.
You know what other Marvel thing I want to see? I want to see Marvel pair up with Disney Lucasfilms to remake Howard the Duck.
That might happen. Did you see Guardians of the Galaxy?
Yes.
Okay, he was in there, and I love
Howard the Duck.
It's funny.
He was in there. He was in one of the cages.
Yeah. I mean, he got out, and I think he talked to Cosmo the dog or something like that.
Perhaps. I don't remember exactly.
Cosmo the dog. It was at the end. It was like the end credit scene. He said something, I think. It was voiced by Seth Green, and like, everyone freaked out. That movie was terrible. Like, the movie they did, though, was
yes, terrible. Yes, it was.
I was so tempted.
George Lucas at his finest.
Leah Thompson was hot, though.
That is accurate.
I don't know who the hell that is.
Cannot disagree with that.
Like, I saw parts of that movie, like, on just, like, you can find clips somewhere on YouTube. And it was terrible.
You know what? I argue, though, that was one of those movies that it was so bad that it's actually a little bit good.
Yeah.
Another movie that's so bad it's good is Waterworld.
Okay. You lost me there.
Really? You don't love stuff?
I've seen parts of that. I haven't seen that movie, but I saw parts of it, and that was terrible.
You don't love stuff, Tim?
I don't like Waterworld.
Stuff! We do this stuff and that stuff and stuff!
Negative, Ghost Rider.
Yeah. Dude, hold on. So I'm very confused. So the reason that one popped into my head is it was on TV the other day, so I watched it again. And it was just as bad, but still funny. And then Nostalgia Critic made a video on Waterworld. And then Rhett and Link made a Waterworld reference in one of their videos. And I was like, why is this a thing again? It shouldn't be a thing again.
It's it's kind of like Cory in the House. Like, that's becoming now a joke, I think. Like, I mean, I don't think Cory in the House was, like, bad, but, like, it was just the way it was, like, so ridiculous that you're like, okay, this is becoming a joke. Like, that's how I think. That's how I at least think of Cory in the House.
DC Adventure, no, we do not live in Texas. I happen to be here on business right now, though.
I was answering the chat because we actually have like a chat tonight, which is awesome.
What up, chat?
Wait, are you guys both in Texas?
No, Tim's at home.
I'm at home. All right.
I'm in Texas.
What was I gonna say? Fuck. But so this is the thing with like the DC movie. So I was trying to talk about this with Batman v Superman. What I think they should have done was like kind of their own civil war where they have like some of the enemies and like some of the heroes pair up against like Batman and Superman lead this charge. And like the idea of the, and I honestly am so annoyed with people talking about the Joker and saying how the Joker needs to be like the Batman. No, this Joker looks so, I've heard he's so much more different than that, and that he needs to be like, and I think he needs to be like the main, like the Thanos of this thing.
Theoretically there's.
It won't be, but.
Theoretically, words are hard. Theoretically, there are three Jokers.
Yes, I've seen that theory.
But no, it's more than a theory. It was
well, yeah, they even do that in Arkham Knight where they're like they kind of do a thing where it's there's so in the Arkham series there's like a thing that happens to Joker where he like takes his blood or something and he can now produce more Jokers, and I don't want to spoil everything. Actually, I'm realizing I'm spoiling something.
And Tim, the chat is talking to you.
Oh, they are.
Yeah.
What up, chat? I don't have it up.
You should.
Oh, Tim, were you in the military?
Am I or was I?
Yeah.
I think the question is, were you in the military?
Negative. Yeah. I think you should yourself.
Let me bring up chat here.
This would be great. I haven't been asked many questions, honestly. It's been awesome.
Everyone start bombarding Gordo with questions for the last couple minutes here.
Yeah.
So I do have one more topic.
And subscribe to my channel.
And it's really, really quick one. And I just want to mention it because I think it's hysterical. Tommy Chong says pot can save the economy.
Tommy Chong is correct.
it's true.
I know, I'm just saying. I just appreciate the fact that it's Tommy Chong.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Who would I get to talk? I was talking to him about this.
Created, as far as I can tell, Tommy Chong has broken into the pot entrepreneur scene with smoke emojis.
With smoke emojis?
The selling point is all buds are Chong approved.
Got him.
Wow. That's interesting.
Sup, Panda, Amanda, whatever you prefer to be called on the internet. Amanda. You joined right as we were about to leave. Because we're getting close to the end here.
I don't want to go to work tomorrow.
Nope.
Like, follow, and subscribe.
Yep. Like, follow, and subscribe to my channel, Greg's channel.
Comment.
Tim's channel.
Don't subscribe to my channel. It's not worth it.
Subscribe twice to mine.
Yeah, that's true, Greg. Yeah.
And for Gordo's channel, go over and subscribe to Gordo's channel and then unsubscribe to show how much you really care.
Yeah. That'd be great. I need to get back on YouTube. Like,
yes, you do.
I worked out way too much and it's awful.
All I hear is excuses.
Exactly. No, hey, you know how busy Tim and I are.
It's true. And Tim posts every day. Greg I think he's released another apology video.
No, I haven't. I've been posting daily, except I missed a Friday.
Oh, well, nice.
I'm not starting on my schedule till August 15th, though, because I knew I had this week coming up and I wouldn't be able to stick to my schedule, and I didn't want to make another apology video.
Actually, did someone just walk by the cat cam?
Yep, I saw that.
Was it the Xander?
I don't think so, because he would have came up in towards me. Oh. Must have been Mindy.
Or the cat.
The Mindy Project?
It could be the terrible, scary...
Stop hating on Greg Gordo.
It could be the scary Mark...
I know, I love just giving Greg...
It could have been, like, the scary Mike Myers cat from The Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss.
Oh, God, let's not talk about that movie, please. Please.
And I use that term loosely.
Yeah.
Dr. Seuss's. I use that one very loosely. Because it's not Dr. Seuss's anymore when you look at that movie. But, yeah. Let's end it there.
Yeah, Dr. Seuss, Cat in the
Let's
Hat.
Let's call it a day.
Tim, if you end up putting this video on YouTube, please insert that.
Insert what?
That's your job. All right, fine. You can have the job back. I'm tired, so it's all yours.
Wait, insert what?
I don't know. What? All right, Greg, do your thing. Oh, insert a picture of Cat in the Hat from
We just moved the VOD over. Yeah. Everyone knows what the Mike Myers Cat in the Hat looks like. You can't unsee that.
Dude, I remember thinking that was a good movie back when I was a kid, and I saw it recently, and I was like, this movie's...
It's horrible.
Yeah,
it's
terrible. It's funny.
There's no story arc.
There isn't, but it's so funny that it's terrible. Or it's terribly funny.
It's not even so bad that it's good.
I've never seen
it. You haven't? Oh, watch it, please. No, watch it. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it with Xander, and you'll never talk to us again.
Oh, speaking of Xander.
Okay, get to it.
Yeah, get to it.
Or do your thing.
Thank you for watching this video. Be sure to check out all the guys here on this podcast over at BigBoxTheGamers.com. Subscribe to all their channels if you haven't already. It really helps us out. We really appreciate it. Like this video, subscribe to the Big Box channel. Do all the things that we always tell you to do, and we will see you guys in the next one.
Keep reaching for the stars.
I love you.
Peace.